Without the use of adhesive tools such as glue, furniture would lack stability even with mortise and tenon joints. That's why ancient craftsmen invented the incredible fish glue as a magical adhesive solution. The greatest advantage of using fish glue is its natural and eco-friendly nature. For elm furniture, fish glue acts as a supportive element to the mortise and tenon structure, allowing for easy disassembling and repair. Unlike modern chemical adhesives, which become permanent once applied, fish glue offers better flexibility. Latex glue, for example, dissolves in cold water and requires soaking in hot water to remove it completely. However, not all furniture components can be bonded with fish glue. So, which mortise and tenon joints do not require fish glue? Northern craftsmen, while creating exquisite antique furniture, have identified some historical guidelines that reflect their respect for the nature of wood in Zhejiang. These guidelines include avoiding intersections in boundary joints, clunk tenons, dragon, and phoenix tenons, wearable joints, and financial and sales joints. The first four types of joints are designed to prevent wood cracking by accommodating the natural shrinkage and moisture of the wood without the need for soaking. The financial and sales joints are kept separate to facilitate disassembly.
Wow, it's amazing. It's really amazing. Today's video is an experiment, which is to test whether fish bleach glue can be used as disassembled furniture. We have a group of customers on hand. Customizers should pay close attention to their special requirements. All furniture must be dismantled and taken alive. After gluing, he can still dismantle it in a few years. So we thought of the ancient people use this fishing glue. In ancient times, there is no glue. All the ancients use water in making furniture. This is a glue drop. Then today I bought such a batch of fish bleaching glue from the internet. And the price is still quite high. Such a small bottle costs $260, which is quite high, much higher than the price of the carpentry and bead glue we are making now. And let's open it first to see what it looks like inside. You can see that it is a kind of yellow, milky yellow. And then it tastes a bit like the glue we used to make the rice paste. When we were young, we pasted curtains, and then in the smell of rice paste glue, and then there's no such smell, just like our chemical product, which had a pungent smell. It still smells better, because it may have something to do with this material. This tastes good. And then now, we go through 2.5 hours, and it's dry. The one on the left is a big red sour branch. This one dries thoroughly in 30 minutes, and then it dries faster than our chemical glue A and B. And this one is from an Indian child's bullet. Let's test these two pieces. After drying out in 2.5 hours, what shall we start now? Start to see if it can be heated to a variety of heating methods to open this glue. Now let's use this electric wind to blow it first, and use lobular rosewood to get started first, because all our customers order our lobular rosewood furniture. If the electric wind can be blown away, it is the best electric wind. Let's have a try at a restaurant. Let's start. Blow the electric wind and insert it first.
And then we adjust this in temperature to the maximum with this temperature.
Then blow closer to the point. Come on.
Come on, start blowing now.
This blow may take a long time. We will try our best to see when we can let go and loosen it as soon as possible.
He said this, first of all, he said that his adhesion is good. Adhesion is still very firm. Because I checked, I tried. You have a look. This firmness is still very strong, and the drying speed is very fast. Therefore, this statement proves that the wisdom of the ancients is particularly strong. This watering must be done quickly and firmly. The wisdom of the ancients is still very strong. Now it is starting to turn.
I blew it for maybe a few minutes.
Let's look at this glue now. It is obviously turned out and can be cut off with fingernails, which shows that this is still effective. Then we will continue to blow. Continue to blow. Now we blow the whole seam. And then after blowing, we will start to use this electric wind to blow, which is a bit slow. We will now directly replace this hot air gun to try it.
This hot air gun has a high temperature.
I'm not good at it. I just put it on the ground and blow it.
This hot air gun is a tool that we usually use carbon wax. When the wax is applied to it, and then the hot fan is used to blow it, so that the wood is allowed to eat the spicy food. The temperature is very high and comes up at once. Its temperature is much higher than that wow.
Its temperature is very high and it is a little white when heated. Let's try this one on. Let's take a look at this glue. What is the situation? The pepper is already a little crispy. I didn't see that I could take my hand down. Let's try it out now. We play rosewood well. We use that hot melt machine to blow it. You see it? You see this temperature is too high. The temperature of the hot melt machine is particularly high. Then we blow the glue hard and extract it. The glue is a little white and has been blown and degraded, which shows that this is not possible and cannot be blown at such high temperature as the thermal volume. We finally came back to this. We used the electric wind to try and see if we could blow the glue.
T-Nac is used to pry. Let's give it a gentle pry and see if it moves. It works. Similarly, when I pry it, I can feel that it becomes sticky and liquid-like. But why didn't it break just now? I need to use a little force with this small chisel. As you can see, when I touch it with my hand, it feels sticky, just like silk. This indicates that the adhesive has melted due to the heating process. However, it takes a long time to heat it up with a hairdryer. Now let's conduct an experiment using this big red sandalwood and soak it in hot water to see if it can dissolve the adhesive. We will start the experiment by placing the sandalwood in a container filled with water at 100 degrees Celsius. Now let's start the experiment. The water is boiling, as you can see. It's boiling rapidly. Let's wait a bit longer. Okay, now let's try putting it aside. All right, let's pour hot water on it and see if it dissolves. All right. We chose this piece of wood with beautiful patterns. As you can see, the adhesive in the middle has obviously come off. Yes, it has melted. The outer layer of adhesive has already melted, right? Now, let's leave it for a while longer and try again. And this time, let me try to break it with my hand. Oh my goodness. It's melted on the outside, but not inside. There is still adhesive inside. You see? Now it's possible that it didn't soak in enough. Let's continue soaking it and give it another try. When making redwood furniture, we need to be brave enough to try new things and methods. We have always been exploring and experimenting. This video might be a bit long, so we need to be patient and wait. The adhesive was stuck on my hand just now, and you can see there is still some cotton fiber left, indicating that the adhesive is of good quality. The quality of something can be judged by its surface texture. This adhesive is very thick, has a beautiful color, and smells good without being fishy or stinky, but also not fragrant. It has a natural and unique scent. This adhesive is really good, which is why it costs so much. A set of furniture may cost several thousand dollars, including the cost of water. Let's wait and see if it will melt. Now let's take it out and give it a try. We can start by using this piece of cloth to pad it, and then try to cut it with our hands. It's loose, and I can feel it loosening when I pry it. It's broken. It's amazing. It has truly melted. I can break it with my hands, which means it has indeed melted. Now let's see how it feels when I touch the inside. You can see that the adhesive has melted and fused. This shows that fish glue can be dissolved through soaking and heating. The temperature should be around 60 to 70 degrees Celsius for it to melt. Heating it to 100 degrees Celsius speeds up the melting process. So this is the result of soaking the adhesive in hot water. It's the wisdom of the ancients. One. That's it for today's video. See you next time. Goodbye.